idea all espresso TV freaks. Now we have a very basic level grinder, which I like to present you. Actually, we have two grinders here. One is the Mazzaconi S with conical burrs, and here one with flat burrs, the Mahlkönig E80 Supreme. It depends what you want, either flat burrs or conical burrs. I think that's a philosophical question, what is better. Both have advantage and disadvantage. With the conical burrs you have less speed. Here you have a bit, little bit more speed. And just do the sound check. So, yeah, quite nice. Also, the particle size distribution looks really good. I like it. And here we have the conical burrs. Yeah, it looks a little bit different. Not so much, but a little bit. But now I want to present the E80 because it's quite new. It's not so long on the market. And what is quite interesting that it's also is quite intuitively. So here you have the different option like a single espresso, double espresso, then for bottomless, for example. And then you have special recipes on top. And one recipe I put here, for example, one cup of coffee. And for each programming mode, you can adjust here the distance of the burrs. You see here, we have now 0.07 millimeters, which means 70 micrometers. And but we should have for this recipe the 75. So first we have to unlock the grinder behind to adjust here. And now we can slowly match here. You see, now we go to 78, 75. It's always step of three micrometers, 72, and so soon it will be 69, yeah, or 70. So now it fits for this recipe, okay? But for the others, it's I put it on 76. So now I have to go a little bit backwards. Yeah, now we have it matching. So it means the 76 micrometers are more or less shown here, roughly, okay? So this is just the scala, is a means of orientation, okay? It's just the orientation. So the exact measurement you have here on the display, and this one gives you more or less an idea where you are. So now we want to make double espresso, okay? But first of all, I want to show you a little bit here the quick and dirty features. So one quick and dirty features is here with the hand. With the hand, you can just with a small push, you can grind, okay? Like some milliseconds, you can grind. But normally, you activate by pushing this button here, okay? So this one is the standard. Yeah, now complete. And you have the editing option, which is shown here. So for example, here you can adjust the time, okay, according to your need. Blurb, so you can say, no, I want it stronger, like with a little bit more, and then you just, now it's saved, okay? Just go back like this, zack. And when you do a double click here, then we go into the recipes, but now unfortunately it's in German, so here we can, I think, for changing, sorry, we need the passport, but the passport I do not have here. So now you have to live with the German, but the numbers are beyond the language, so it's quite okay. I just want to show you here with the special recipe. This one is not active now, so if I like to edit, of course it's now time-based. Yeah. So now it's 3.33 seconds, but I like to adjust here, like 3 is okay. Or then I go to 2.99. Yeah, like this. Okay. Then I go down, it's for the two cups. Here you see the distance of the berth. And with the distance of the berth, you can adjust to your need, okay? If you like to do this way. And then we activate the system by pressing here. So now it's active, okay? And now we can go back. You see it's active. Now, theoretically, there should appear now this function, okay? So then you see I programmed it with a different berth distance in case you like to reach it, then you go just a little bit more left until it shows that it equals. But what I want to do originally is just to do double espresso. That's it, so really fast. Now we do the leveling part in an easy way. Now the tamping. And now the espressing, okay? The extraction part. I put here now 3 seconds on pre-infusion. Okay, so not that, yeah, okay, I think it's okay. But here with the Electra Verve, you see that it needs a little bit of rubber for the insulation of the vibration of the drip tray. Zack. And as you see, the outflow is not that homogeneous. It is, so you clearly see that I did a mistake, and the mistake is in the leveling and in the tamping. So I was not that super precise. I'd just like to show you the difference, okay? So when you are not very precise, then you produce a different result. So this is why you always have to be careful in leveling and tamping. I did it more the quick and dirty way, and if you do quick and dirty, it's okay, but then you have more tolerances, okay? This you have to accept. That's the price of quick and dirty, but yeah. Even the quick and dirty is nice. Cheers, Pim. Cool. In my opinion, it's a really nice espresso. It's a E80 presso, yeah, so welcome to the grinder. And yeah, it's a really cool, intuitively style. I like it. Really good job, Malkönig. Okay, see you. Ciao.